Thank you. Hi Wing Gaming, sorry I didn't see that. Welcome back. Just finished the inking. And we'll do the interesting part, the watercolors. Oh. Oh no. I see the chat like few seconds later because I have my iPad up to see my stream because the PC is a little bit far away from me. So I'm sorry if I'm late in answering you. So usually I use a reference photo for my drawing, but I never follow it for coloring. I like to go to the shed aquarium. I'm sorry. I go at least once every other week. But I don't follow the colors. I like to do my own palette and choose different colors. Just deciding which color to start with. Let me see. Yeah. Usually I start with the lightest color for the first layer, first wash, and then going darker, medium tone, and then the darker tone. I'm not used to work on a smaller scale though. Usually I work minimum 18 by 24 inch. But the small, of course, it's easier on stream. I also record the stream and do like speed up paint on YouTube. And scanning the artwork is easier when it's small. In my area, I didn't find someone that offer the large scan artwork. There's a flatbed scanners, big one for artworks. Didn't find them. The nearest one in Chicago, it's very expensive and it's like 3 hour drive. But I learned a trick on Photoshop. You can scan a larger picture. In parts. And there is a photo merge on Photoshop, like a tool. And it makes it really good. As if you scan it on a large flatbed scanner. I got stung by a jellyfish when I was a kid.